it's Ashton.
And it is John. What is up, guys? We are back with another reaction video. In today's video, we're going to be watching
Dracula, Angry Video Game Nerd, episode 57 by the channel
Cinemassacre. It's very important to support the channels that you love. The link is down below in the descripto. Suggestion from Grantee's Notes. Grant, thank you so much. You guys can also help support the channel if you want to. Just click on that link down below in the descripto and throw it down through Streamlabs. And then you pick one of the next videos that we react to. Just keep it under 10 minutes. Include the video's link, title, your email. Now let's see what Angry Video Game Nerd has for us today.
Okay.
His originality in his trailer is just amazing.
Yeah, he managed to get a really, like, the song is just super catchy. Like,
yeah, it is.
I don't know who wouldn't like it.
Dracula. Blah.
Oh, another night. Shitty games. That's all I do is play shitty games, and I have so fucking many I'll probably be playing till the dawn. It's a sacrifice to the soul, and it's sucking me dry. How appropriate, because tonight, it's Dracula. Now, when it comes to Dracula games, most people instantly think of the Castlevania series, but yeah. I'm going to delve into the fucking catacombs of hell. Our first exhibit is the count on the VIC-20. And what the fuck is a VIC-20? Well, it's an old Commodore computer from 1980. Thought the Commodore 64 was primitive? Well, check out the VIC-20. Look at that cartridge. That's what you call a game. Trying to jam the fucker in is a real bitch. Even worse than the Intellivision.
He's like, God damn.
He's watching it.
Yeah, he is.
The graphics are non-existent because it's a text game. It says, I see I was put to bed. It's afternoon and I overslept.
Yeah, no. I wouldn't be playing that.
I'm gonna write, get out of bed. Don't know what out is. What shall I do now? Wake up. Don't know how to wake something. I don't know what to tell it, but I have the instructions, and it gives you some suggestions of words you can use. So let's try climb. Can't do that. Yet. Oh, so you're teasing me. Go.
This is so bad.
I also need a direction. Go right. Don't know what right is. Go left. Don't know what left is. Eat pillow. Yuck. Okay, so I ate pillow? I didn't expect that. Get up. I'm in a bedroom. Closed window, brass bed, north. Okay.
What the fuck is this game?
North? What shall I do now? Okay, so I went north. What did that do? Go east? Okay, what shall I do now? Go east again? Use one or two words only. Oh, okay. I'll give you two words. Fuck you. Don't know how to fuck something.
Next up, Dracula. That's a terrible game. Holy
What's
shit.
Cool about this game is that you actually play as Dracula. I'm trying it out on the Intellivision 2. It's basically just a redesigned model, which you think would be an improvement. But what in the holy mother of ass is this? If the old Intellivision had a simple
Jesus.
Plug, why does the newer model have a big fat ass AC adapter?
Fucking brutal, man.
You leave your grave and you go around sucking people's blood, which is kind of cool. Dracula has a big mouth like Pac-Man. The only
Jesus,
thing
he
can't
does.
Kill are the wolves and the police who throw wooden stakes. You can turn into a bat.
Some primitive police, okay.
Comes after you. And the only way to kill the police is to transform people into zombies and send them after. But to control the zombie, you have to pick up the other controller while controlling
oh,
Dracula
shit, that's
at
elaborate.
The same time. So it's like Raiders of the Lost Ark. You really need a second player. The instruction manual text is pretty funny. You say you're always thirsty, Count Dracula? The police harass you and birds and animals are unfriendly and you're allergic to the sun? Well, my man, I'd say you've got some grave problems. Who would call Dracula my man? Next, we have Drax Night Out on the NES. Now, this game was never released, so what I'm holding is a rare reproduction cartridge, which is
oh,
the
wow.
only way it can be played. There's also a big promotion for sneakers, the Reebok pumps. You play as Dracula trying to leave his castle in the middle of the night to find his lady love, Mina. There's a bunch of villagers who kill Dracula by simply touching him. I don't know what kind of sense that makes, but your only method of attack is waving a medallion or shaking some object. I really don't know what it's supposed to be. but if you use
Jedi mind tricks, what do you mean?
It may seem simple, but you don't always have this item. Sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. I think it has something to do with the blood meter, but I really don't know. So you can't count on it most of the time. So you have to flick switches which either control barriers to block your enemies or activate traps. Rolling balls, Frankenstein monsters, ghosts, or dropping chandeliers. So you need a lot of strategy to use these traps at the right time. When you stun people, you can suck their blood, and I think you can turn into a bat, but I've never seen it happen. But your only real power-ups are the Reebok pumps. They let you run faster and jump higher. You really need
gotta love those Reeboks.
Without them, you get your ass handed to you.
That's what I call a power-up, and that's what I call a promotion.
True.
Reebok pumps. You ain't shit without it. Pump it up and air it out.
The game also has a time limit, which is a real pain in the ass. If you get stuck on the stairs, you're dead. You can't drop down or you die. So those stairs are your worst enemy.
This is terrible.
Fuck.
You can't drop down or you die? He's fucking Dracula.
Fuck!
You think gravity doesn't apply?
Even though it pisses
it's like three
me off,
steps.
I can't really complain because this game was never released.
For good reason.
Somebody took a shit and buried it and then someone else decided to dig it up. It's like, what do you expect?
True.
Alright, on the Game Boy Color, let's try out Dracula Crazy Vampire.
Ooh.
What kind of title is
Game
that?
Game Boy Color, I forgot
Dracula's
what those cartridges
vampire,
look like.
And he's crazy, sure.
It's been so long.
I never had one of those.
Sounds like Phantom of the Opera.
Game Boy Advance is much better.
That's what I have.
Which sounds like Pink Floyd. Anyway, it's a typical overhead action exploration game. Yeah, there's not really much to say. What's Dracula's deal? He's got a big head and his face, he's like, duh. It's kind of redundant and there's no map, so I really don't know where I'm supposed to go. Just going around throwing bats at dogs. That's real creative. Okay, now let's go for the
just imagine somebody whipping a bat at a dog.
Sesame Street, really?
Run, which is really weird. If you pick hop, that's all you can do. Just hop your way through the whole stage. I've never heard of something like that. Imagine if in Super Mario Brothers, if you had a choice where you could only run or jump. So you pick a number and the count starts talking.
Oh god, no.
10.
Man, that's weird. So you gotta go around and find the same number or things that add up to that number. So when you finish that, you go up in the clouds and you have to hit the blocks till the numbers come up, and then you hit the bell. That's about the extent of that.
I mean, a learning game for kids, at best.
Okay, so this is Bram Stoker's Dracula on the NES.
I mean, it's like a five-year-old game, but...
Right.
Just as much as the movie's based on the novel, I suppose. I guess you're supposed to be Keanu Reeves. What's this? Blocks with question marks? Right out of
Mario?
Super Mario Brothers? Yeah, even the stages are kind of similar. Only seconds into the first level, I come to a wall. There's nowhere to go. I try jumping down, but that doesn't work, so I had to fuck about until I found that you're supposed to do this ground stomp thing. Yeah, by jumping in the air and hitting down. Why the fuck do you gotta do that? The music is just a scrambled mess of 8-bit
chaos. They totally
copied.
Yeah.
I've made it to the first incarnation of Dracula, a shadow that emerges from the wall. There's not enough time
that's
to
annoying.
Hit him.
You can't
either
even see
get
it.
Out of the way or try to attack. Most of the time, I can only hit him when he's going the other way. He's just a pain in the ass. Next, we have another Bram Stoker's Dracula.
God
this
damn.
Game was released on both the Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis.
Okay.
Both versions
okay.
are pretty much the same. Your sword is a joke. It's about as effective as a butter knife. The gameplay is pretty simple. It's your average platformer. You wander all around, fighting a boring array of enemies, and search the place for an exit. You can't go in the exit until you find some strange old man who thinks about a weapon. Then you can go find that weapon or head straight to the exit. What's that all about? He thinks of a weapon? Can you read minds? Why doesn't he just
think
give you
a
weapon
somewhere.
And say, here, now go to the exit? It doesn't even tell you that part. The bosses are senseless. The first one has this gravitational pull that sucks you toward him. There's no strategy. You'll never be able to get close enough to attack him and avoid him at the same time. So the only thing that makes sense is to stand right next to him and just keep hitting him and hope that he dies before you do. The strangest enemy I've noticed is this green plant thing. It just looks like something's wrong. When I saw another one, I figured out what it is. You see, they're supposed to be coming out of the walls. What's this shit? It looks like it's suspended in the air. Were they too lazy to just flip it around?
I think they were.
I really fucking hate these goddamn spears. Oh, F. I mean, fuck. How the hell am I supposed to get past these things? There's no fucking pattern. your only hope is to dodge the first one and then just run through it. In most games, when you get hit, you're invincible for a brief moment. But here, you have no recovery time. You just take damage till you die, and it can drain all your life in one fast combo.
Stupid.
Fuck! Game over? That's it? Overall, it's a mediocre...
We've come a long way, ladies and gentlemen.
...exploitation of the Coppola movie. Wait, who's this? Fred Fudge? Fred Fox?
Fred Fox?
That's a perfect name.
Fred Fox! Oh my god, Fred Fox! Oh my god, it's Fred Fox! Oh, Fred Fox.
Okay, one more. Now really, this could go on forever. Bram Stoker's Dracula on the Sega CD. I already comment on this game in my Sega CD review, but it's just so bad. It has impressive graphics for its time, and it has all these cutscenes where it shows clips from the movie, but it's so badly pixelated and it's pointless. There's also this guy with a pipe reading a book.
Jonathan Hart.
Why? I actually did manage to get to Dracula, at least in his first form,
like,
and he looks
Mortal
just
Kombat.
As laughable as he did in the movie. But the most ridiculous part is when you die.
What the hell? Is that clip even from the movie? I don't know, maybe it's from Bill and Ted.
The game looks amazing for its time, but the control is what kills it. It's so awkward trying to jump. You fall through shit and the attacks are so delayed.
Stupid.
It's impossible to turn around and hit your enemies before they hit you. You just wish you had a whip or a sword or something. I mean, not your bare hands. All you get is this stupid little kick to kick the fucking rat. Yeah, that's all it is just rats and bats. How many fucking games
just
need to have
beating
bats?
Up
like,
fucking animals left and
Dracula,
right.
But why do so many games have so many fucking bats?
Seriously, I fucking hate bats.
Oh my god.
Throw it at a dog.
I'm sick of it all.
What?
Morning sun.
Throw the bat at a
me.
Dog.
Why?
Because that's what happened in the game earlier.
Oh.
It's just dumb. I want to see it. Coming soon. There it is, guys. The legend himself, Angry Video Game Nerd.
That was good.
Those were terrible games, though. Holy shit. The first one does take the cake as the worst, though.
Yeah.
Type something. Get up.
Ooh.
Or get out of bed. Don't know what out is.
I don't know how to fuck something. Like,
that was probably
what?
The best moment of it.
Yeah, for sure.
If you guys like that video, go and subscribe to Cinemassacre. The link is down below in the description. Very important to support the channels that you guys love. Peace out.
Bye.